حكم العقبة فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة صدق الله العظيم. Ladies and gentlemen, I recited few verses from the holy scripture that is known as Quran. And I would like to share with you the great message of God that has been given through these ayahs. Basically, the message is that Islam or Muslim people, they are not only for the Muslims, but Islam is for all the humanity. Whenever the time of the crisis comes to any people, to any nation, to any those who are oppressed, Islam is supporting all those oppressed people. You know the word, the very first word in these verses of the Quran was Aqaba. Allah or God, He says, why don't you tackle the obstacle? Aqaba is the obstacle. For example, if you are hiking on the mountain, you have so many obstacles on the steep way, and then you're trying to remove those obstacles. That is called Aqaba. So Allah is trying to make us realize what is the obstacles for the humanity, for the human beings. So He is saying the biggest obstacle for the human beings, if any time, in any part of the land, in any region of the world, people they are living under the oppression, people are living under any kind of injustice and wrongdoings, they are deprived of their freedom, the freedom that was given to them by their Creator as the first basic human rights. So all you as the human beings, go for them, support for them, and free all those people who are under any kind of oppression. And that's why we are here today. My brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, let me remind you, and I would like to take this opportunity, that people, they think Islam is only 5 prayers a day, or fasting, or as we know, 5 pillars of Islam. But believe me, these verses, when they came in the beginning days of the Islam, when the prayer was not made obligatory, when the fasting was not there, when any other pillars of Islam were not there. The very basic teaching of Islam that God has given us as the Muslim to serve the humanity, to serve the people, to serve all the Muslim people. So that's what the message of God is. And we are here, I swear by God, if they would not be the children of Syria, if they would not be the Muslim, you will see the Muslim every time for support of any kind of humanity, for any people of the world, that we are all with the Muslim people. That is the message of Islam. That is the commandment of God that we have been following here as the Muslim people. May Allah reward everyone. Ameen. People know how this revolution started. We think because we are adults that we know better than the children. But in this revolution, the children knew better. The children of Syria knew better. Say, free Syria!
Free Syria!
Free Syria!
Free Syria!
And let me tell you how it started. While the Arab Spring has started in many countries, in Tunis, in Egypt, and other nations, one of the school children in Syria put a scribble on a graffiti on a building. And it said something very simple. 3 words that started this whole revolution. 3 words that no adult could have written. Children, yes, school children. And they said, Doctor, it is your turn. Doctor, it is your turn. The president was a dictator,
is a doctor, and they refer it to him. Right after that incident, the security forces rounded up the houses, one by one, took each child and tortured them extensively. Tortured them to a certain level where they took off their nails. They took off their hair. They did things that are so disgusting I cannot even mention to you. What happened after that? The parents went. The parents went and just said, how can you do this to the children? You have humiliated me. You have done everything that is bad and unjust to me. And now you want to take out my children? Imagine if you were in this situation. All the parents here, imagine if you were in this situation. What would you have done? You know what was the reply? The reply is, you don't have children anymore. You don't have children anymore was the reply given by the security forces when this happened. And guess what happened after that? The Syrian people revolted and said, all of them are our children. All of the people that have been tortured because of this, the three words, are our children. Say, free Syria.
Free Syria.
Free Syria.
Free Syria.
When do we want it?
Now.
When do we want it?
Now.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce the sponsors. This took a lot of effort, took a lot of time, but this is the least that we can do. We talked to people in Syria on the ground. For the people that think this is a waste of time, hear this. Please send us, you're an advocate. Well, after this event, send this to others. The people in Syria are telling us on the ground, their morale is boosted when they see events like this. Their morale is boosted when they see events like this. And you have no idea, no idea what school children would have, and how many people are waiting to see this video. And the first protests were even started by children. The first protest started in schools. Imagine, school children boycotted schools and said, we will not go to class. We will not go to class until this regime is gone. We will not go to class until we gain our human dignity. MASS is a sponsor, Muslim American Society. Karma Arfali, can you please come forward? We're gonna spend a couple minutes to briefly talk about the sponsors, and then we're gonna start.
Okay, so as I woke up this morning, I checked the news, right? I wanted to see what am I going to talk about today? Who from the people who are killed am I going to mention today? And a sad fact is this was easy to choose a handful of children who were either tortured or harmed or killed just today in Aleppo, Syria. The first story that I want to tell you guys is about a boy named Muhammad. And what had happened was some shrapnel actually hit his leg and his thigh bone was shattered. And the Free Syrian Army, the area that they had, you know, taken over, the place that's supposed to be secure, the hospital could not even help him. So they had to send him to the hospital where the regime is. So can you imagine being sent to the hospital where the people who harmed you are the people who are the only ones who can actually help you? Imagine the shattered dignity of the people. And I want to tell you about another girl who was sitting in her mother's lap today, just sitting in her mother's lap on the balcony. When a bullet came through the window and entered her cheek and was stuck in her throat, and the hospital could not even help her. She ended up dying because there is not enough medical aid that can actually help this girl. And then another boy named Ahmed, something that had exploded near him, something hit his ear, and his ear was almost about to fall off and was almost, you know, taken off, and there was not even enough, like, material, like, anesthetics to numb the child while they were putting him under the procedure. And when he got out of the procedure, he found out that his father had been killed. And these are the day-to-day lives of the Syrian children. And the final person that I want to mention today is a one-year-old boy named Hussein. And today, a bomb fell on one of the buildings, and the building collapsed over an entire family. The whole family was killed, and he was the only one that survived. Because when the building was attacked, his mother was breastfeeding him. And when the building collapsed on top of him, her body sheltered him, and they were able to make him live. And this is why we are here today. We are here to support the children who don't even have families anymore, who have lost everything. I was thinking back about it, and I thought to myself, when I was 5 years old, I have a scar on my right knee, just a small one. From when I was 5 years old and I jumped off a swing and my knee it open because I fell on it. And to me, that was the most traumatic experience. And when I see the children of Syria and what they see every day, whenever we watch the news and they say viewer discretion is advised, and they tell us to please take small children out of the room, the children of Syria do not have that viewer discretion. When that happens, when somebody gets shot before their eyes, they bleed to death in front of them. When somebody loses a limb, it happens in front of their eyes. Can you imagine the trauma? And today, just when I came here, they gave me a sticker, I think it fell over there, but the child that I am walking for today had a heart attack and died that way because of the fear that happened before his eyes. He had a heart attack. This is why we are here today. We are walking for the children, and that's all I wanted to tell you guys. And I'm so glad that you guys all came out. This is such an awesome event to be at. Thank you.
In society, the next on the board is Brother Mohammed Mardini. He is a board member of the Coalition of Free Syria, which consists of Syrian American Society and other several organizations like Sham Foundation, who does a very great job that many human rights organizations can't do on the ground. Please welcome Mohammed Mardini.
Assalamu alaikum all. When the Syrian government silenced the peaceful voices of children in Daraa back in March of 2011, we gathered ourselves in this blessed community and started Coalition for Free Syria to support the Syrian people, to provide them with moral support, and to create awareness about the devastating situation back there. But that was not enough. So we started Sham Relief Foundation to provide people with desperate needs with humanitarian relief and basic support to survive day-to-day needs. And we launched many, many relief campaigns for that goal. Last one was in Ramadan, where we served over 1,000 food baskets inside for families inside Syria, in Damascus and in Homs and in many other places. Each food basket can feed a family of six for a whole month. Nevertheless, and to collaborate our efforts with other communities nationwide, in California, in New York, in Washington, D.C., and many other places, we decided to join the National Syrian American Council, SAC, and we are opening a SAC chapter here in Dallas to send and to convey a strong message to the officials in Washington, D.C. that the children of Syria shall not be massacred while us keeping silent. Last thing I want to tell you, when you have a moment tonight, please visit us at shamrelief.org. Sham, that's S-H-A-A-M. relief.org, and donate wherever you can. And remember that whatever you could spend with your family in a dinner outside in one night could be enough to feed an entire family in Syria for a whole month. Thank you for joining us.
All right, the next on the board is Sister Amin Arab. She's a very active board member of Council on American Islamic Relations, an organization that I'm part with. Please introduce, welcome her.
I'm with CAIR Dallas. Here's something I wrote for the children of Syria. Here's to you. When bombs explode and houses crumble, it's the children that pay the price. When bullets penetrate and blood flows, it's the children that pay the price. When regimes change and governments fall, it's the children that pay the price. Who is there to hear their plight? Who is there to wipe their tear? Who is there to save them? Who is there to hold them? With shattered dreams and hopeless faces, their innocent eyes questioning us. Where are you? Why don't you stop? Don't you see our pain? Don't you feel our suffering? This poem here is dedicated to all the children of the world that are suffering, particularly now the children in Syria. Our presence today here is a testament to the fact that we do care. We do see them, we do feel their pain, and we do feel their suffering. Thousands have died, thousands more have been injured, and many have been maimed for life, both physically and mentally. Thousands have fled their homes in fear. Our faith requires us to help the helpless. We cannot turn our backs on those that need a helping hand. Regardless of who is to blame, the killings must stop for the children's sake. This walk is a small gesture to speak up for humanity, to speak up for the children of Syria, and I thank you for joining this nationwide rising for humanity. Thank you.
You guys, I'm from I'm from 6th of April Youth Movement in Egypt, and we have a chapter in the U.S., and when we heard about the Walk for Syrian Children, we jumped in and sponsored it. We're a very proud sponsor for today's event because we support humanitarian efforts, especially for something like what's going on in Syria, and we also support every initiative for every revolution that's going on in the Arab world. We started the revolution in Egypt, and we're continuing through the whole Arab world, so... I'm very proud to be here, and because the American chapter sponsored the walk, we had 9 cities in Egypt sponsor also the walk in Egypt, so we are in every city today. Thank you.
All right. So now we are going to begin the moment that you all have been waiting for, the moment that everyone here has been waiting for. And I myself, I am very proud of the turnout tonight. You guys are the reason that the children have hope. You guys are the reason that those in Syria who are fighting for the freedoms and fighting for the children, you guys are the reason why they have hope today. We are about to start the walk.
Bless you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Peace, Syria! people!